All right, this is 17 licks inspired by the Eric Clapton song Cocaine. I'm going to go over the entire solo that you just saw at the beginning of this video. That's 17 total licks. I'm going to break them all down note by note, talk about the techniques I'm using, talk about the scales and notes I'm using, and also tell you how to be able to develop the techniques to be able to play these licks. So there's a ton to get out of this lesson. Please check out the Black Belt membership on my website, guitarlickdojo.com. When you are a Black Belt member, you get access to that full solo that you saw at the beginning of this video in a interactive video with interactive tablature, meaning you can slow section down, sections down and loop sections. Very cool. You also are able to download the tablature in Guitar Pro in PDF format, and you have access to a backing track, so you have something to practice these licks over. So definitely check that out. It's free to try for 7 days. You can cancel anytime. So definitely check that out. All right, with that, let's get into the licks. Here's the first lick. Okay, there's the first lick. This is a E minor pentatonic lick. And we're playing this lick in the most common position of the E minor pentatonic scale, which is up here in the 12th fret. That position up there that most of us all know very, very well. And the first note I'm hitting here is the 15th fret on the second string bending up. And that is a downstroke. Now you hit that, my little playing tip here, is to not pluck it extremely hard. You're really, you know, really driving through the string with a pick. Don't do that. I got much better sounding result here when I picked through more, just more smoothly. So going through the string quickly, I'm holding the pick firmly, but I'm not really picking it really hard like that. It's more of a smooth, almost a strum. So that's my advice for that. When you get up to the 12th fret on the first string, you're hitting that with an upstroke. So first two notes is downstroke, upstroke. That picking pattern, although you can do different things here, that seems to work best for most people. That's what I would recommend. Next note, 15th fret on the second string, downstroke, and then the 12th fret is an upstroke. So we're just going downstroke, upstroke, really straightforward on the first four notes. Next part of the lick, we get into this bend up on the 14th fret, pull off, bend down, and then pull off. That really basic blues rock type of lick there. I'll talk about in the second, as far as technique goes, this is probably the most challenging part of the lick, just getting that bend to land perfectly one step up. So I'll show an exercise in a second to help you get that down. The next two notes are 14th fret on the fourth string. And that same rule I mentioned for the first note, keep your hand very relaxed. There's no need to really, you know, pick through the string really, really hard as you're going through that. I would do it just more smoothly. Keep your hand relaxed and just go through the two notes very smoothly like that. That's what worked out best for me when trying to get a good sound out of this lick. And then the final lick, I'm landing on a downstroke. So the 14 is upstroke, downstroke. And then the last note, the 12th fret on the third string, is a simple downstroke. And that's it, that's the lick. So as far as technique goes in this lick, one of the most trickiest part of this lick for a lot of people, and even for more advanced players who don't know that they're not hitting this perfectly, is getting the bend up so it's perfectly one step up. Makes a huge difference if you do not do your bends so they land perfectly on the note you're trying to hit. If you do that at just a half step, may not sound too great depending on what you're playing over. You wanna make sure your bends are perfect. So a good way to check that is to just do this. Bend up a full step on the 14th fret and then play two frets up. And those notes should sound exactly the same. This should sound exactly like this. If you're a little bit off, then you know your bend is not good. So it's a good exercise just to do that. Great little exercise to get your bends perfect. Great little warm up. The other thing you can do is once you get that basic sound down, just do that one lick over and over again. And that'll help your bends get to sound good. Again, getting those bends sound different, sounding perfect, landing on those notes, that's the difference between this lick sounding bad and this lick sounding great. So make sure you're nailing those. That's the first lick. Okay, so there is the second lick. This one, we're moving one position down in the E minor pentatonic scale. It's still basically the E minor pentatonic scale with one extra note that's in the E minor scale. That is this note right here, which is the second of E, that's the F sharp. Other than that, we're straight E minor pentatonic in this position right here. So this is a good lesson for hitting the entire fretboard. Notice that you saw in the solo at the beginning, I pretty much worked over in every position of the scale at some point, of the E minor pentatonic scale at some point. So this is a good lesson for getting into the fretboard pretty well. Now this lick, we're starting downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke. Again, keep the pick hand nice and relaxed. And the next part, and this is really the key part of this lick, I'm sliding up with my middle finger up from 11 to 12, then back to 11, and then pulling off the 9. So it's like this. And then downstroke, 12 on the 9 on the 4 string. And then finally a slide up, just a downstroke to get up to the 9th fret on the 3rd string. Now, the key to getting this lick to sound good for me was to really just try and make it smooth, sound smooth. It's kind of a legato style lick, and you only get that by keeping your hand relaxed. Number one, keeping your hand close to the fretboard so there's not any silence in between the notes. You're just kind of bleeding from one note into the next instead of... Notice the difference between that and this. So, hand relaxed, hand relaxed, left hand close to the fretboard, and trying to get that to sound smooth. That will help out a lot. So, as far as technique goes, the takeaway here is the slide up and back on the 11th up to the 12th, then pulling off to the 9. That. Now, to get that to sound good, what you want to do is make sure that the timing's perfect. And you can get that down by just doing that. Slide up and back, then pull off. If that slide is not perfectly on, it will be very noticeable. The lick will not sound good. So get that down. Really simple to do. Just play those 4 notes and try to get it down with a metronome. So you're just playing perfect 16th notes, perfect 8th notes. Just make sure that timing in that pull off and the slide is very even. And that will help you out a lot. All right, so there's the next lick, and in this one, a couple takeaways. I'm doing that bend up, bend back, pull off thing, just like we did in the first lick. And then we bend up again, and there's another critical lick where those landing in those bends exactly a step up is perfect.
And this lick is a little bit different from the last lick because this one gets a little more staccato. Basically, in the second part of the lick, I'm doing this. There's a much more staccato, I'm plucking harder type of feel. And what you'll also notice is when I get to the second part of the lick, I'm playing it with my middle finger. So that second part of the lick, this lick is pretty basic. And two downstrokes there, by the way. This next part of the lick, I bend up on the 10th fret on the second string. And then when I hit the 10th on the first string, I'm hitting it with the middle finger of my right hand. And then I'm kind of maintaining that bend while I do that. So it's like this. And then pick and bend down. You can play that in different ways. But that's how I'm playing it here. And then finally, downstroke on the 10 on the second string, upstroke on the 9 on the third string, and then land on a downstroke on the 8. And again, of course, we're in E minor pentatonic still. Just like pretty much every other lick in this lesson. Big takeaway here for the technique is that hybrid pick. And you want to make sure that that's perfectly in time. If you're not used to playing with your fingers on your right hand at all, this is a great little introduction lick to that. To get that down, simply bend up on the 10th fret and follow that up with the middle finger playing the 10th. Just get used to playing that simple, really simple lick in time. And then once you have that down, you'll get this lick to be able to sound a whole lot better. So that is the third lick. All right, there's the next lick. We're moving down the fretboard again. We're still in the E minor pentatonic scale. We're just down in this position down here. There's one exception note here, and that is the 7th fret on the second string, which is the F sharp, similar to this F sharp we played a few licks ago. Same note, so basically the E minor pentatonic scale with the exception of that one note, which we don't spend too much time on at all, so it's really E minor pentatonic. This lick, technique-wise, let's break down what I'm doing with the hands here. Down stroke on the 4th fret on the 3rd string, and then I bend up half step on the 7th fret on the 2nd string. And notice that when I'm picking the 7th fret, I'm also doing that with my middle finger again. So this is another lick where I'm doing some hybrid picking. And that gave me the sound on this lick that I was looking for. You can, of course, pick that note. In that case, I'd do an upstroke with the picking hand. But the sound I liked out of this lick, I got by playing with my finger. So you can choose to do that if you want. Now, the next part of the lick is another one of those sliding back and forth and then pull off licks. So once I get up to that 7th half step up, notice that to get in, to begin that slide, I don't pick again. Really important part of this lick because I'm kind of going for a smooth sound here. I want this lick to sound really smooth and in legato. I'm able to do that by not having a lot of picks and by not having a pick before I do that slide part. So an even more challenging version of the lick number 2 where we also had a similar side. So that slide up and back and then pull off to the 5. So 7, slide up to 8, slide back to 7, pull off 5. And then 7, downstroke on the third string. And then 5, middle finger on this finger, on your picking hand again. Again, you can choose to pick that if you want, but again, I like the sound of the finger there. Downstroke on the 7 on the third string, and then we're doing some pull-offs, 4-0 and 2-0 on the third string. So I did that both with my pointer finger, index finger. And then we end up on a slide, sliding up to 5. I also, when I hit that note, I'm also hitting the open string, open top string, the open E string. Gives a little bit of extra thickness. So big technique takeaways from this lick. That's unique to this lick is really these open string pull-offs. Nailing those, getting those pull-offs to sound good can be challenging if you're not used to playing pull-offs to open strings. So to get that down, in this lick specifically, where we're playing with our index finger, just do that lick over and over again. Get those pull-offs down, and that will help out a lot with the sound of this lick. All right, there's the next lick, and in this one we're back up a little bit on the fretboard. So first few licks we worked our way down the fretboard. This lick we're moving our way back up a little bit. And we're up here in this region of the fretboard, still E minor pentatonic scale. We're working our way through a couple positions, so it's that position and then also this one here. Working our way through a couple positions, we are on the 10th fret on the first string downstroke. 8th fret is an upstroke, so just down up, really simple. And then I slide up to the 10, 10 to 12. Basically doing that type of thing. Now, to get this part to sound good, what I really focused on is similar to a couple other licks here. I really focused on keeping my fingers on my fretting hand really close to the fretboard and making sure the notes bleed into each other. I was going for kind of a very, very smooth legato effect here. So, that's what I was going for. So to me, this lick sounded really good when I really had no space between the notes. It was just really smooth between the notes. Again, you achieve that by keeping your hand really close to the fretboard, barely moving your fingers off the string when you move from note to note. That will help you get that sound. And also the picking. Remember not to pick too hard. Pick pretty softly. This hand is really relaxed. You're holding the pick firmly. You're hitting the note perfectly on time. You're just not plucking through. That type of picking has its place, but not in this lick. So back to the picking pattern here. When I get up to the 10th fret on the first string, I do an upstroke. Downstroke, 12 to 10 on the second string. Upstroke on the 8th, downstroke on the 10. Upstroke on the 9 on the 3rd string, then downstroke on the 8 on the 2nd string. Downstroke, upstroke, 9, 7. And then slide down when you hit the 7 on the 4th string. You're sliding to that note with a downstroke. And then another downstroke to land on the 5 on the 4th string. Thank you. Okay, so there's the next lick. A couple techniques at play in this lick. And we're back in the E minor pentatonic scale, of course, with the exception of that F sharp that we have thrown in there for just a second, but basically E minor pentatonic. We're back down on the fretboard a little bit. So basically in this position here. And of course we slide up a little bit up to this position. So still E minor pentatonic, we're just in this position down a little bit lower. Now, first three notes, I'm doing that hybrid picking thing. So downstroke with a pick on the four, and then pick the three on the second string with your middle finger. Then downstroke again on the four. And then we get to the first beat of the first bar, or the next bar, that's where we're landing on the five, with a downstroke of the pick. You could also do it with your middle finger too. Either way you want to do it. In fact, I think in the solo at the beginning, I think I did it with my middle finger. But either way. Now the key part of this lick is when you hit that five, you notice the next note is this eight that's bent up on the second string. I'm not picking after I hit that five, so it's like this. Kind of a unique technique there. But I think sounds really good. I think that sounds better than. So that's what I'm doing there. So pick once, slide up and bend up, full step up. Then the last part is just a simple seven fret on the second string, bend up, back, pull off. And we're only bending up a half step there. And that's the lick. So a couple technique things to practice out of this. Again, the hybrid picking. You can do something that simple to get that picking down. Just eighth notes at this. Get that timing in getting, get comfortable using that middle finger. And then of course that big slide up that I went into. Just get used to doing that where you're. Getting that slide in time and that bend up so you're perfectly one step up. And that's the lick. Okay, this lick we're doing some double stops. And we're starting off sliding up in this position of the E minor pentatonic scale. We touch in a little bit into the major scale here. So if you analyze the notes here, this note right here is basically outlining a D-shaped chord. We're in this position on the fretboard. And the next notes, I'm actually hitting the G sharp, which is the major third of E. So this is one note where we get away out of the E minor pentatonic territory. So slightly different, but it's just really that one note. The next note, we get back into E minor pentatonic territory, and then the rest of this lick is straight E minor pentatonic. So we touch slightly outside of the E minor pentatonic scale, but not much. It's basically, you know, one note. Still in E minor pentatonic territory. So as far as the lick goes, this is more hybrid picking. We are doing a downstroke and we slide up to the 11 on the third string, and then picking the higher string, the 10th fret on the first string with our middle finger. So same thing when we slide up to the 13 to 12. And then same thing when we're playing the 16th on the third string and the 15th on the first string. Keep your hand very close to the fretboard when you're playing this. You want these notes to bleed together really well. You don't want big breaks between the notes. something I've mentioned through a lot of the other licks here. The 15, when we land on that note, that's the downbeat of the next bar, the first beat of the next bar. And then this is just basic pentatonic stuff from here on out. Downstroke, 17, 15 on the second string. Then a bend up, 17 on the first. Then downstroke, upstroke on the 17, 15 there. 17 on the second string, downstroke. And then the next bend is a 19th fret, 1.5 steps up. So basically the lick sounds like this so far. Big 1.5 step bend on the 19th fret. And that's the most challenging part of this lick. This is one of the most challenging licks in this lesson because of these bends here. So I'll come back to that 1.5 step bend in a second and how we can get used to that. After that big bend, we come down 19, 17, downstroke, upstroke on the first string, downstroke again on the 19th, and then we do on the 17th and 15th fret of the first string, we do a bend up, bend back down, pull off, and then 17, 15, downstroke, upstroke, and then finally land on the 17 with the downstroke on the second string. So the whole lick is basically this. Something like that. Now the really tricky part here, and it took me a while to get this lick to sound good too, is that big 1.5 step bend. And if you don't hit that perfectly, it sounds really bad. This is one of those cases where if you don't hit the bends perfectly, you can get away with it in some cases. If you are doing, you know, some positions, you can kind of get away with it. It's not going to be too noticeable. This will be pretty noticeable. If you try and pull off the 1.5 step bend and you don't quite nail it, it's really obvious and sounds really bad. So what you want to do is do that strategy where you, when you're practicing this, bend up and then check to make sure you're bending exactly 1.5 steps up. So the 19th fret, bend up 1.5 steps, is the same thing as the 22nd fret. So we want to make it sound like this. So that little exercise right there will let you know if you're hitting it right. If you're having struggle, if you're struggling with bends, or even if you're good at bends and you just want to, you know, sharpen your ear and sharpen your bending skills, that's a great little exercise. Just something that simple. A good thing to practice after you get that is to go into move between that of step and a half bend and then just a normal full step bend. So move between the full step bend and the 1.5 step bend. Get used to moving, doing those different bends kind of close to each other in the lick so you can train your ear and then train your hand to be able to hit that properly. But that's the big technique, the most challenging part of the lick. If you can get that part of the lick down, the rest of the lick should come together pretty easy for you. And if you get that down, the lick's going to sound really good. All right, there's the next lick. This is really basic pentatonic stuff. Basically, we have one note here where we hit on the 14th fret on the first string. That's in the E minor scale, basically, the F sharp note. But other than that, we're straight E minor pentatonic in this position. The position we all know and love. Now, in the rest of the lick is straight pentatonic. So first note, downstroke on the 15th fret. Upstroke on the 12, and then pull off 15, 12 on the second string. So it's like this. Little triplet. Bend up on the 15th fret on the first string. The downstroke. and then downstroke, upstroke, downstroke. Bend up on the just downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke. We're just straight alternate here when we're starting at the 15 on the first string after that bend. So bend up on the 14th, bend back down, pull off to the 12. Then 14, 12, downstroke, upstroke. Then downstroke on the 15 on the second string. Upstroke on the 12th fret on the first string. And then downstroke again on the 15. So technique-wise, I don't think there's anything new here to talk about. I'll just reiterate the same thing I've said with a lot of these licks here. Just keep your picking hand loose. Don't pick the notes so hard. Keep it nice and relaxed. And you'll get this lick to sound really good. Okay, so here's the monster lick. This is certainly the fastest lick in the solo. Although the finger movements are not that hard. The first part of the lick is really, and this lick is, again, E minor pentatonic pretty much all the way through. I don't think there's any exceptions at all in this position here. For 1 second, we go up from that position up to the 17th fret on the first string. So it's basically that normal home E minor pentatonic position with that one note on the 17th fret. Now the first part of the lick is fast 16th note triplets, and it goes like this, slowly. Really simple sequence based lick. So this actually isn't too difficult to play. It's really fast, but the fingering is actually pretty difficult, pretty easy. Downstroke on the 12th fret on the third string, hammer up. Then downstroke on the 12 on the second string, and then upstroke to the 15 and then pull off. Again, there's not really a right or wrong answer here. Some places I have strong preferences for how to do the picking pattern. This one, whatever feels comfortable to you, as long as you hit these notes, it doesn't matter a whole lot. Upstroke, work it when you get to the 12th fret on the second string. That works just as well. Downstroke on the 14 when you get to the third. Upstroke when you get to the 12 on the second again. So then 12, 15, 12 on the first string. So that first note of the 12 on the first string is a downstroke, upstroke to pull off 15 to 12. So that first 12 notes of the lick, and then the downstroke on the 15 and the second, I didn't mention that. That's really the heart of the lick, is that first 12 notes. Now the next part, we get into just straight 16th notes. We're past the 16th note triplet timing. So 16th note triplet timing is 6 notes per beat. So, and then 16th notes are 16th notes. 4 notes per beat. So this next part is, there's a really quick slide. But it's basically, the next part of the lick is this. It's basically 12 on the first string. You do a quick slide up to the 17 and then pull off 15, 12. But it's 16th note. So it basically sounds like this. I'll do it without the slide once. It's basically that, but you're doing a slide. That is probably the most challenging part of the lick. So I'll talk about that in a second, how you can develop that. But after that, you do pull off 15-12 on the first, the downstroke, then 15 downstroke on the second string, upstroke is a 12 on the first string. And then we get up to the second string, 15th fret, bend up. Upstroke on the 12th on the first. Downstroke, 15 on the second string, pull off. Then a quick triplet bend, 14, bend up, bend down, pull off. And then 14 on the fourth, third, and then fourth. That's a downstroke, upstroke, downstroke. Notice the finger roll there. I'm playing that with all with the third finger. 12th fret on the third string, then upstroke, and then downstroke, upstroke on the fourth string to the 14 and 12. Now, as far as technique goes, I'll give you two things to work with. First is just the basic sequence. That thing at the beginning of the lick. To develop that, if you're not, you don't have that under your fingers at all, a really good thing to do is just pick two notes, two strings in the E minor pentatonic scale pattern, and just do a six note pattern like this. So I'm starting on the 12th on the second string, hammering up. Then on the first string, 12, 15, 12, and then finally 15 back on the second. So it's just a circular pattern. Once I got that basic fingering down, I would try another set of two strings in the E minor pentatonic scale. So I'd try on the third and second string. That will get you used to the picking, it will get you used to the finger movement, and once you get those basic sequences down, it's really easy to play that through the entire scale. And then obviously really easy to make licks out of that once you have that down. So really good practice for speed is just those really simple, super simple circular patterns. The next part is this slide up, and I've mentioned this before. To get used to slides, the best thing to do is to do them in time. So play a simple lick. Just like that, simple four notes, slide up and back and pull off, just to get used to getting the timing with that finger down perfectly. Once you get that timing down, you can play licks like this and get them to sound really good. There's the next lick, nothing special here. We're in the same position of the E minor pentatonic scale. Nothing special at all there, no notes outside of the scale. Downstroke, 12, 14, hammering up. Doing two downstrokes actually in the 12 on the third string with a little slight bend. And then 14 and 14 on the fourth and fifth strings, and then land with a downstroke on the 12th on the fourth string. Make sure that those notes, the 14 on the fourth and fifth string, they don't bleed into each other too much. You don't want it to sound like this. You don't want that, you want this. It's two separate notes, and you do that by kind of rolling your finger a little bit so that when you play the 14th and the 5th, this finger, your ring finger in this case, is not fretting the 14th on the 4th string. It's raised up a little bit, it's kind of muting it. So that's what you're doing to achieve that sound. All right, next lick, we're still in the minor pentatonic scale in the same position. And we're doing this thing up here. Really simple blues rock stuff, bending up a full step. That's just a downstroke on the 15 and an upstroke on the 12. And then we get up to this part up here. That's a downstroke on the 12, upstroke on the 15. And then we do a quick triplet hammer on pull off with a downstroke. That's what it sounds like together. Downstroke in the 15, upstroke in the 12, then 15, 12 on the second, then bend up 14 on the third, pull off, and those last two notes are downstroke, upstroke, 14 on the fourth, 12 on the third. So a big takeaway from this lick is that triplet, I think. And really the big takeaway is the timing, transferring the timing between 16th notes and the triplet. So I would get used to that. If you're not comfortable with that speed change, play the two 16th notes and then the 16th note triplet. Played together, it would sound like that. That little triplet right there is a great little lick, something that Eric Clapton and many others do all the time, just as a simple trick to throw in a lick. So that little triplet is a really good thing to know. Okay, the next part of the lick, we're basically in E Dorian, you could say now, because we're including a note that is not in the E minor pentatonic scale, not in the E minor scale, and that is the major sixth of E, which is this C sharp note right here. And we're only there for a second, so you could probably still look at this as E minor pentatonic, but that's a really unique note. That's not really repeated anywhere else in the solo. So that's, as far as the scales go, that's the big takeaway here. Now, as far as the lick goes, it's basically like this. And to get this to really sound good, I know I've said it a lot in this lesson, but what really got this going for me is just the really soft picking. It's on time, it's accurate, it's just not very plucky, you could say. It's more smooth. Hopefully what you're seeing on the camera is translating to what I'm doing there. But it's just, you know, it's a very smooth picking action. It's not a very firm, aggressive picking action. Doesn't really work for this type of lick. This is also a good lick for you know, that moving to different types of bends. It's important that you hit the one step bend on the 15th note on the first string here, and then the 14, the next one, needs to be exactly a half. If you play that a full, doesn't quite fit. So make sure you nail those bends, and then the last bend is also a half step up. So we do upstroke on the 12th and the first string, downstroke on the 12th on the second string, and then we do an upstroke on the 14th on the second string now, and that's also a half step bend. Again, you don't want to hit that note right there. If you bend up a full step, It's going to sound terrible. So really watch that. Good exercises to do for this are just like other ones we've done before, where you bend up, bend up a full step, make sure you're hitting it right for both the full step and the half step bend. And then also the simple bend up, bend down, and pull off. Also good exercises to develop the skills to be able to play this lick. All right, there's the next lick. This is straight E minor pentatonic territory, and this is very Stevie Ray Vaughan inspired type stuff here. Just bending up twice on the 17th fret on the first string. And it's the second bend up is the one first beat of the next bar. So it's. And then we just do downstroke, upstroke on the 17, 15. And then two more bends up on the 17. Then upstroke on 15, downstroke on the 17 on the second string. And then the last few notes are just 15, 17 on the second string, upstroke, downstroke. And then last note is a 15 with a slight bend up on the first string. So the whole thing together is like this, basically. Again, I'll give the same advice here for playing this lick. Focus on that picking, getting it smooth, not plucking too hard. That's the motion you're looking for there. That's the mechanics you're looking for there. And that will get the lick to sound good. So focus on that. All right, there's the next lick, and here we're back into straight E minor pentatonic scale. This is a very Eric Clapton inspired type lick here with some of that triplet stuff going on that we've seen before. So those are the big pieces of this lick, but really stock Eric Clapton stuff. Bending up on the 15th fret on the second string. 15, 12, 15 on the second string. Just a downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, really simple. And then we do that triplet hammer on pull off. That's a 12, 15, 12 pull off. Then downstroke on the 14. And then 12 upstroke. So. And after we get to that hammer on pull off, land on the 14 on the third string. So this. We kind of descend down the minor pentatonic scale, just 12 with an upstroke on the second string, 14, 12 pull off on the third, downstroke on the 14th on the fourth. So it's upstroke on the 14th and the third when we get back up to that, downstroke on the 14th and the fourth, and then 12 upstroke. So far we basically have this. Then we finish off the lick with a simple 14, 12, 14 on the 14th string. So that's it. I don't think there's anything unique to this lick that we haven't covered before. The big piece of it is that triplet. If you're not used to that, just make a simple lick out of that. Something you can do is just basically the starting at the 12th fret on the second string and the 15th, going to the 15th on the second string, that part of the lick, and then the triplet and land on the 14th. So just this. A great little lick to practice. get that little lick down, and that's really easy to translate to other places in the scale, so you can take that and move that to other places within the E minor pentatonic scale, or obviously other scales as well. So a great little lick to practice there. All right, the next lick, really straightforward E minor pentatonic again. This one's really a simplified version of the last lick, right? A lot of the same ideas. Bend up on the 14th, downstroke. Hammer on pull off on the 12, 15, 12, little triplet. 14 again with a downstroke in the third string. And then upstroke with a 12 on the second string. And then finally a 15th bend up on the second string. That first 14, the first note in the lick, is the one of that beat. So make sure to land that if you're playing this over a jam track, which you should be doing. That's where that note lands. Now the next part of the lick is, basically what we're doing in this lick is we're playing one lick, and then we're playing the same lick again, just a little bit higher up on the register. So repeating the same idea twice, a neat little idea for a lick. The next one, we start bend up 15 on the second string, and it's the same lick, it's just moved up higher up in the scale. We do that 12, 15, 12 pull off. 15, 12 on the first and second string, or second first string with the downstroke, upstroke. So that second lick right there is the same picking, it's the same basic lick, we're just on two different strings. Same idea, same rhythm, same exact rhythm, same exact picking motion with the right hand. So really simple idea for a lick, but it sounds really good. Both of those licks happen on the first note of that bar. So it's basically one, two, three, four. The first lick happens in the one of that lick, and then in the next part of the lick starts on the one of the next bar. So really cool, very simple lick. All right, there's the next lick, and this is basically a continuation of the last two licks. We're just kind of building up to the last note in the lick here. And this one, we're taking that triplet idea again, and we're just doing a repeating thing. Really simple. Something like that. Really simple idea, something we've done throughout the lesson. Again, E minor pentatonic scale. Basically in the same part of the fretboard. And this lick in itself makes a pretty good little exercise. If you just want to get the basic hammer-on pull-off down a little better, it's good to play this lick over and over again without that bend at the end. So just do this. Great little exercise to develop just basic mechanics to play through the pentatonic scale easily. But we basically just repeat that four times, and we bend up on the 15th fret in the first string with a downstroke. So, and that's the lick. All right, there's the final lick. Nothing too complicated here. This is just basic blues, rock, Stevie Ray Vaughan type stuff. And just bending up in the first 17th fret on the first string, the downstroke. And then the next four notes is 17, 15, 17, 15. That's just downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke, downstroke. So just straight alternate picking. So it's and then land on a downstroke on the 17th on the second string. And that's the lick.